Halo, selamat pagi Las Vegas. Hari ini hari ketiga gua di Amerika dan sekarang hari yang ditunggu-tunggu gua pergi ke SEMA Auto Show. Wah, gak sabar ya pengen lihat seperti apa keseruan di SEMA. Tonton videonya sampai akhir. Cus. Terima kasih ada yang salah dengan mobil ini karena Halloween, lihat deh. Ada kaki yang melambai keluar di luar pintu. Ternyata itu cuman suatu aksesoris mobil. Hampir gua kena prank. Gimana Bapak Hadi?
Oke.
Are you excited?
Very excited.
Very excited.
Tentu saja dong, kita bawa Mas Hill dan Expo Bandung juga datang ke SEMA Las Vegas.
Oke.
Untuk show dedikasi kita kepada Indonesian market.
Sesampai turun dari bus, kita langsung disambut dengan mobil-mobil yang direstorasi dan dimodifikasi. Mesin-mesinnya terutama, wah ini spektakuler sekali. Langsung mata gua terkesima dengan lihat restorasi modifikasi dari Amerika di SEMA ini. Di Indonesia Nissan 280Z disayang-sayang di sini diacak-acak, bro. Buat teman-teman yang mau datang ke sini, SEMA tuh besarnya luar biasa. Sampai dari gedung ke gedung mereka menggunakan Tesla di under tunnel yang mereka sebut dengan nama Tesla Hyperloop.
Alasan mengapa mereka membuat tunnel ini karena SEMA itu begitu besar terbagi beberapa gedung.
Mobil ini keren banget, F86, mesinnya WireTech. Wah. Dan ini juga dua Nissan mesin. 350Z. Untuk penggerak belakang menggunakan satu mesin dan penggerak depan menggunakan satu mesin lagi. Jadi ada dua mesin di mobil ini. Gokil. Rivian, SUV EV buatan Amerika.
Di SEMA juga mereka ada perlombaan modifikasi dan restorasi mobil yang dibangun oleh para builder di Amerika dan mancanegara dan hasilnya gila,
terakhir
keren
sana.
Abis.
Iya. Nggak, jadi kalau Mustang baru tuh ada 3 mesin. Coyote, Subaru, sama Predator. Ini Subaru yang di tengah-tengah.
Di tengah-tengah. Nah itulah untungnya jalan-jalan sama reporter Hilarus Satrio atau Hilsat. Gua dapat banyak informasi yang gua mungkin nggak tahu sebelumnya.
Sekarang gua lagi di West Hall dan yang luar biasa di sini tuh banyak sekali produk-produk detailing dari cuci mobil, poles mobil, sampai satu produk yang paling menjadi suatu perhatian gua yaitu paint protection film yang begitu banyaknya di hall-hall pada SEMA tahun ini.
Tahu nggak apa kata Hilsat? Ini kan 23 itu Nissan, ini 213 kata Hilsat. Kalau salah salahin Hilsat ya. Sorry.
Gila, gila banget.
Satu alasan utama mengapa gua datang ke SEMA adalah gua ingin melihat paint protection film atau pelapis cat film expel di booth SEMA Auto Show 2023. Mereka ternyata memiliki banyak sekali dealer di mancanegara. Di Amerika saja mereka punya 3000 dealer dan di Cina 1800. Belum di negara lain seperti di Asia, mereka sangat berkembang. Satunya di Indonesia dan gua saat ini memegang cabang yang di kota Bandung. Mengapa gua ambil produk Expel? Karena memang gua melihat produk ini memiliki masa depan yang sangat baik, memiliki ketahanan gores yang bisa self healing dan juga clarity yang mumpuni. Expel juga memiliki kaca film. Yuk kita interview dengan representatif dari Expel. Halo teman-teman semua, sekarang gue lagi di booth Expel. Gue pengen nanya banget nih dengan langsung representatif dari Expel yaitu Eric. Hi Eric, nice to meet you.
Hey, nice
first
to meet
of all,
you.
Can you introduce yourself? What's your position in the Expel?
Sure, my name is Eric Cummins. I'm the director of international sales for Expel.
Okay. I would like to ask questions. First of all, can be Expel used for the architecturals?
So automotive films, sometimes have been applied to architectural applications, but it's not recommended. You know, we want to make sure that we're not absorbing too much heat because you risk cracking the glass. So I would always refer to the professional to ask them and make sure that they're comfortable with the type of glass that it's being applied to. And whenever possible, use a film that's designed for architectural applications.
All right. So, is there any difference in the way they reject the heat for the film?
So heat rejection is a very common question. It's very confusing to end consumers because we say heat, we say IR, there's UV, and ultimately, there's different grades of film. So depending on what the preference of the end consumer is, we have different versions of the product. Hmm. But yes, you have films that can look very dark, but not block much heat, and films that are very light that can block a ton of heat. So again, I would go and make sure that, you know, the installer of the product is communicating exactly which films they have and explaining what the performance of that film is going to be.
All right then. Second question is, what is the advantage of XPEL XR plus window film?
So that's a great example of a film that can block a ton of heat without being too dark. So XR Plus is a nano ceramic window film, which is going to basically block a lot of IR. So you have different parts of the IR, the visible light spectrum, which is visible light, IR, and UV. So UV is the type of heat that's going to cause fading and skin damage. Visible light is the light that you can see, and then IR is the heat that you can feel. So with something like a ceramic technology, what you're able to do is really increase the amount of IR that's rejected without having to go too dark on the product.
Wow, that's really cool. And when an advertiser describes block 90% of it, is that even possible?
It goes back to the same question, which is heat. You know, heat is not a scientific measurement. You can measure the temperature. There's all different ways that you can measure. But usually when someone is saying 98%, they're referring to the IR spectrum. You know, ultimately, if somebody wants to know how much heat a film is going to block, I would ask to look at the TSER, which is the total solar energy rejected. That's going to be the best indicator of how much the temperature is going to change.
All right. So how much is it the XPEL have for that TSDR?
So all different products. You have the highest end performance that you're going to get is going to be something that looks very, very reflective. So for a light product, you can get films that will reject 46% of it, where you can't even tell that there's a film on the glass. And then if you want something that's completely reflected in the mirror, you can block more than 80%.
Wow, that's really cool.
Yes.
Okay. And then next question is, what is the difference between UV heat and IR heat? I see that it's being mentioned around when a store sells window films.
Right. So UV would not really be heat, I would say. It goes back to, these are the light spectrum. So UV is the part of the light spectrum that you can you can't see and you can't feel, but it's doing damage. So about half of fading in homes or, you know, on anything that you have is caused by UV. Skin cancer, these types of concerns are mostly UV. And IR is the heat that you can feel. So the heat that you can feel is going to be IR. There's all different ways to measure it, which is again why if someone wants heat, IR is a good indicator, but the TSER will give you a better picture of how much energy is actually being rejected.
So it's more accurate in TSDR, right?
It's more accurate, and there's different measurements. IR can be explained in so many ways. If you look at different marketing materials, they may list it as SIRR, IRER. Oh, IR rejected.
That's really complex, I guess.
There's different wavelengths, which is why I refer back and say, overall, you know, there's great demonstrations that can show you how much you can feel on a heat lamp or on a car, or you can go back and look at the TSER.
Okay, cool. And then the last question is, what to look for when shopping for window films?
When shopping for window film, you know, I think one of the biggest things to look for is the actual installation business. You know, there's a lot of great films, but the application techniques and the way that they take care of their customers is important. And I think that's what we pride ourselves with on XPEL, is that we make sure that we vet our customers thoroughly, we provide training, and we provide the support. So if there's issues, you know you're taken care of. If you have a great quality product, but it's not applied correctly and it's not cared for, you're not gonna be a happy customer. But if you go to a place that is, you know, carrying a reliable product that takes care of their customers, then you're going to have a better experience.
Well, that's cool. So it's a nice product and nice service.
Exactly. Right? That's right.
All right. Thanks so much, Eric, for your explanation. Hope all the best for XPEL.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Okay. Jadi teman-teman semua, itu dia penjelasan mengenai window film XPEL. So teman-teman yang cari window film kendaraannya, boleh dong cek XPEL. Itu dia penjelasan mengenai kaca film XPEL. Buat yang masih penasaran tentang produk unggul PPF XPEL, bisa langsung hubungi di bawah ini. Namanya apa, bro?
Maverick.
Mirip kayak siapa ya?
Hah?
Mirip kayak siapa?
Dari West Hall, kita menuju East Hall menggunakan Tesla Hyperloop. Ngomong-ngomong Tesla Hyperloop, harusnya ini tuh autopilot ya, tapi karena gagal, jadinya manual. Di East Hall lantai 2 terdapat banyak peralatan bengkel dan juga perlengkapan bengkel, pastinya bakal bermanfaat sekali untuk bengkel gua di Wet Gloss. Mereka juga memiliki teknologi terkini, jadi kita juga ingin mengupdate teknologi di bengkel kita supaya kita bisa memberikan pelayanan kepada konsumen jauh lebih baik daripada sebelumnya.
Teman-teman, kita lagi ada di Paris, Vegas. Kita lagi dinner bareng teman-teman XPEL. Jadi, dealer dari mancanegara, terutama di bagian yang Asia, region, datang semua untuk kita ke SEMA melihat booth dari XPEL Internasional. Keren banget ya. Sangat bangga jadi bagian dari keluarga XPEL untuk XPEL Indonesia, terutama di Bandung. Rusir. Mana XPEL Bandung?
XPEL Bandung.
Oke teman-teman semua, hari ini hari kedua di SEMA. Memang kalau ke SEMA itu nggak cukup satu hari. Kita rencana mau 3 hari, tapi nggak tahu ya kalau hari ini bisa beres.